Here's a story about how I lived in an amusement park every single summer before I would travel around the country with sea lions. It all started when I saw that my favorite amusement park, after being closed for 9 years, was reopening. Then I noticed they were adding sea lions. Well, a ton of emails and phone calls later, I finally got a hold of the owner for the sea lion show, who offered an internship. Within a month of interning, the owners actually pulled me aside and offered me a full-time job, which I had to accept. I mean, it was my first marine mammal job. After I accepted it, I was given a place to stay inside the park, actually located near the roller coaster they were renovating at the time to be opened the next year, aka my backyard was the wave pool. I'm actually going to break this story down into a couple different parts. My time living in an amusement park and my gypsy life on the road with sea lions. Both equally as crazy and both equally as fun. For those of you who have never seen my page before, hi, my name's Cierra and my life has been kind of crazy. Living inside an amusement park was one of the craziest times of my life. And yes, when I say I lived in one, I mean I was one of 7 people to have a key to that park. My washer and dryer were underneath one roller coaster, and my house was put next to another one. All of the workers in the park actually would often refer to us as the Sea Lion Girls and treat us like royalty, which to say out loud feels both kind of embarrassing but also kind of badass. I mean, it definitely felt like we owned the park. We were contracted in, so we didn't have to follow any of the same rules as any of the employees. I mean, the park was our home after all. Walks across the park in the middle of the night to go get your laundry were definitely the creepiest. I mean, sometimes a worker would forget to shut off the carousel lights and sounds, or the water slide announcement would randomly go off about weight, which definitely hits differently in the middle of the night. But just everything about living there, the looks the Uber driver would give you when they drop you off at your back gate to the park, to what I'm going to talk about next, which is a love story that you'd only see in the movies. From sneaking around to late night adventures, I hope this next one doesn't get me in trouble. Are you ready for the ultimate summer love story? Where one girl who lives in an amusement park is introduced and friend-zoned at first by one of the park employees. However, she ends up winning him over by her awkwardness, charm, and, oh yeah, her sea lions. Well, welcome to my life. Now, like every couple, things started off rocky, but before you know it, you have a secret meetup spot where I will not disclose and have fun late night and early morning adventures. Now, I was told that I can't spill all of our stories yet, but this is one of our favorites. One night when we were going on our walk around the park, I all of a sudden sparked this crazy idea to go up to the water slide, which at the time was the world's tallest water slide. I mean, this thing is so tall that when planes go over it to land at the airport across the street, I swear you could reach up and touch one. But clearly we are very similar in the aspect of loving thrills. I mean, hello, amusement park. So obviously we ended up racing to the top, but you will never believe what happens when we get up there. And of course I'm out of time. Stay tuned. The part two you've been waiting for. I mean, it's just a girl living in an amusement park deciding to go up to the world's tallest water slide with her boyfriend in the middle of the night. What could go wrong? Well, once we were at the top of the water slide, it was honestly like something you'd see on TV. From getting a look at the entire park and city lit up, to lying down and just watching the planes fly right over us. Like, it was perfect. Until. Remember how I told you guys about the weight announcement I would randomly hear at night when I would take a walk to go get my laundry? Well, I found out that announcement was on that exact slide. It was super loud and it was repeating anytime it would detect motion. It spooked us at first, but then we just thought it was funny until we saw a flashlight. We quickly looked down, saw somebody was there, then we looked at each other like we had just seen a ghost. After a couple seconds of silently panicking, we saw that they started to walk away until the wait announcement went off. He turned around, shined his light, and I swear we made direct eye contact. Then my boyfriend and I exchanged looks of basically like, well, it was fun while it lasted. Then a miracle happened. He was called over to the other side of the park. A few seconds after he left, we ran down, got back on the path, and realized that we just put a whole new level of thrill to an amusement park. Since you guys love hearing about my stories when I lived in an amusement park every summer with my sea lions, here's another one just for you that's almost too legendary to speak of. But I'm gonna tell it anyway. YOLO. So you know how this amusement park also had a water park too, with slides, a lazy river, and yes, a giant wave pool. Well, one day we had an idea, and I'm not talking about the occasional night swimming we would always do. No, this was a legendary idea. This adventure is about the time we brought one of our sea lions across the park to the wave pool with us to go swimming. How, you may ask? Well, baby Lils was at the time literally more of a pet to us than some animal you'd see at a zoo. We took her everywhere with us. She'd ride on the golf cart, she'd come hang out with us in our living quarters, she even went down a slide at a fair. I mean, you get the picture. So one day after the park closed and everyone left, we loaded Lils on board and started making our way across the park. But just as we were about to arrive, that's when security saw us, came over, and this is where it gets legendary. I ran out of time. Part two up next. Here's a story about the time we took our sea lions to the wave pool. Yes, you did hear that right. Sea lions to our wave pool when we lived in an amusement park. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, feel free to go check out the other TikToks to get caught up. Are you all caught up now? Perfect, let's go. So like I was saying, after the park was closed, we loaded up our baby Lils onto the golf cart with us. And as we were making our way across the park, that's when security saw us. Dun, dun, dun. Just kidding, it wasn't really a big deal. Security never says anything to us. Why? Because us sea lion girls literally live in the park and have done way weirder and more questionable things than one of our sea lions were. riding in our cart with us. But those stories are for a different day. When security saw us, they just ended up waving and going about their lives. Once we got to the pool, before letting her jump in, we obviously checked chlorine and pH levels just to make sure it was safe for her to play in, and when it was all good to go, we got her down and off she went. She obviously had an awesome time. Like, I had never seen her swim so fast and jump so high when playing with us. We stayed about 20 minutes, but that memory will last a lifetime. If you're new, hi, my name's Cierra, and my life is kind of crazy, but that's what happens when you truly live your life by the phrase YOLO. Now, who's ready for another story?